So welcome to my video. So in this video we are going to discuss about introduction to robotics. So this video provide you the basic of robots. So starts with what is robot. So all are aware about robot and robotics. So first of all, what is robot? A robot is an autonomous or semi-autonomous machine or a virtual agent that is capable of performing tasks and actions without any human interventions. They are called robots. So otherwise, an electromechanical device that is reprogrammable, multifunctional, sensible for environment, that is another definition for a robot. So robot is a autonomous or semi-autonomous machine that works without any human interventions. That is the basic definition for a robot. Next one is, what is automation? So most of us have a little confusion because what is automation, what is robotics, both are same or both are different. So first of all, I am going to learn what is automation and what is the difference between robots and automation. So first, what is automation? Automation refers to the use of technology, machines or systems to perform tasks and processes with minimal or reduced human interventions. So it is the use of technology or machines or other systems to perform tasks as well as processes with minimal or without any human interventions. Automation and robotics are closely related concepts, and robotics is a specific application of automation. So automation is a very broad one. Robotics is one of the subcategory in automation. Robotics is a specific field within automation that involves the design, construction, operation and programming of robots. So automation is a broad one. Robotics is a subsystem of automation by using robots. Next one is what is the role of robotics in automation? So robots are one of the primary tools used to achieve automation in various industries. Most of the industries automated by using only robots. Industrial robots are the main components to automate any manual processes. So they can be programmed to perform a wide range of tasks, from simple and repetitive action to complex and sophisticated operations. Robots are used in industry for simple operations like pick and place, loading and unloading, to the complex one like painting, assembly, inspection, etc., etc. So robots are particularly useful in situations where human involvement might be inefficient, dangerous and impractical. So robots mainly used in industry in the areas like the jobs are inefficient if a manual labor are doing, or the work is harmful to human means, that kind of jobs are robots will helpful in that area to avoid that risk as well as to improve the efficiency of that work. Next one is laws of robotics. We all are aware about Isaac Asimov. So he is the father of robotics. So he framed three important laws. All the robots must obey this three laws. First law is, a robot may not injure a human being. So first law one is, a robot must not injure any human being or through inaction allow a human being to come to harm. So first law is very, very simple and clear. The robot doesn't harm any human being. Law number two is, a robot must obey orders given to it by human beings. So second one is very simple. A robot must obey the orders of human being, except where the such orders would conflict with first law. So when we heard about this law, our mind automatically moves to the movie called Indran. In that movie Indran, one scene, this law directly applied to that movie. So we will match this law with that movie. Third one is, a robot must protect its own existence as long as such protection does not conflict with first or second law. So third law is, the robot must protect its own existence, but it doesn't conflict with law one as well as law two. These are the three basic important laws of robotics. It is framed by Isaac Asimov. Next one is different types of robots. Robots are classified into different types based on different categories. So starts with industrial robots. These robots mainly used in industry for the purpose of manufacturing as well as different industrial applications like grinding, painting, welding, drilling, assembly, inspection, etc., etc. So these robots are designed for manufacturing and industrial applications such as assembly lines, welding, painting and material handling. Next one is service robots. So these robots are mainly used to assist human beings in various conditions. First one is domestic robots. They are used in household applications like cleaning, cooking, pet care, etc. Next one is healthcare robots. They are used in medical industry as well as surgery to assist doctors as well as medical workers. Third one is entertainment robots. They are purely designed for entertainment purpose. The examples for toys as well as robotic pets for the examples of entertainment robots. Next one is autonomous vehicles. So these robots are designed to navigate and operate without human interventions. Examples are self-driving cars, drones as well as autonomous delivery vehicles are the popular examples of autonomous robots. Next one is medical robots. They are used in medical industry for the purpose of doctor assistance, surgical assistance. Next one is military and defense industries. So robots designed for military purpose like bomb disposal robots, unmanned aerial vehicles are the examples of military as well as defense industries. Next one is educational robots. They are used to teach kids as well as they are used to teach advanced concepts. So in foreign countries, most of the developed countries used robots to teach their kids. The countries like Japan follow uses this robot most commonly. So intended for educational purpose, these robots are often used to teach programming, robotics, even engineering also they are used to handle. Next one is agriculture robots. They are used only for the purpose of agriculture. In agriculture field, they are used to like planting, harvesting, as well as monitoring the health of. If you use humans in underwater explosion or space mission, it is dangerous for them. So in that area, we are using robots like underwater robots, rover, landers are used to underwater explosion and space missions. Next one is humanoid robots. So the name itself give the meaning of that robot. It looks like humans. The structure of the humanoid robot looks like a human being. So these robots are built to resemble and mimic human actions and interaction. They are often used to research, entertainment as well as human robot interactions. Next one is nano robots. Nano means very small in size. So tiny robots at a nano scale designed for medical and scientific applications such as drug delivery and targeted treatments. Final one is swarm robots. These robots work together in a coordinated manner to accomplish tasks often inspired by the collective behavior of insects as well as animals. So they are small in size, they are work in group, that's why they are called swarm robots. Next, what's the reasons behind use of robots? There are three different reasons are there. First one is jobs that are dangerous for humans. The jobs like handling nuclear waste or mining, that kind of jobs are very dangerous for humans. So in that area, we are using robots instead of humans. Next one is repetitive jobs that are boring, stressful and labor intensive. These kind of jobs to be replaced by robots like pick and place operations, material loading. These kind of operations are very boring, repetitive and stressful to human labors. So robots are replacing these kind of jobs. Third one is manual tasks that human don't want to do. Some jobs we are not interested to do. The jobs like septic tank cleaning, drainage cleaning, these kind of jobs are humans are hesitant to do. These kind of jobs can be done by robots. That will helpful for humans. These three are main reasons to use robots instead of humans. Next, we are going to discuss about different applications of robots. First one is manufacturing. In manufacturing field nowadays, all manufacturing industries are using robots, robot assembly lines to manufacture their product. Like car manufacturing industries, nowadays all the car manufacturing industries are using robotic assembly line to do all the manufacturing process. Starts from parts manufacturing to assembly, inspection, painting, etc. are done by only industrial robots. Next one is healthcare. Nowadays, healthcare industries are very advanced and very developed. So, the healthcare industries are using different kind of robots to assist doctors as well as medical workers. They are used to support surgery. They are used to care elders. Next one is logistics and warehousing. So, robots are applied in warehouse for automated material handling like pick and place, loading, unloading, order picking and inventory management. So, all kind of activities are done by robots itself. So, they increase the speed and accuracy of the logistics operations. Next one is agriculture. In the agriculture field, robots are used to do the activities like planting, harvesting, monitoring crops, precision farming, etc. So, they optimize the agriculture process, reduce the manual labor and improve the overall yield. Next one is space exploration. So, robots such as rovers and landers are deployed in space missions to explore planets, moons and other objects. They gather data and conduct experiments in extreme environments. They are very harmful for humans. That's why we are using robots to do these kind of activities. Next one is transportation. Autonomous vehicles, self-driving cars, drones are the best examples. Nowadays, these kind of robots are applied to replace the human workers. Nowadays, we are using robots to construct buildings, dams as well as large structures to reduce the human work to improve the speed. Next one is entertainment. So, entertainment robots such as robotic pets, toys, these kind of robots are used to improve the quality of life. Next one is defense and security sector. So, in that sector, military robots are used to save the life of human being. Next one is education research. In this field also, robots are used to improve the research activities as well as quality of education. Last one is environmental monitoring. So, robots equipped with sensors can be used to monitor environmental conditions such as pollution assessment as well as rain prediction, earthquake prediction. These all kind of activities are done by using robots only.